Pinpoint weather good for Utah first forecast.
We're in for another cold night out there. We're seeing skies starting to clear after what was a rather cloudy day out there. 34 in Ogden, 37 Salt Lake, 31 Logan, and 33 Provo. Winds are generally light out there, and some places are seeing more clear skies than not. But if you're taking a look at the whole state, 28 in Price, that's the cool spot out there. Mainly 30s on the map until you head farther south. But just how cold will tonight get, and as we head into the weekend next?
This is Utah's CW30 News at 9.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Rick Aaron. Welcome to the CW30 News at 9. New developments in a shooting that happened earlier today in Magna. Police have released two juveniles they thought were suspects. Now the search continues for the individuals who fired those shots. This happened at a Wendy's restaurant located at 3500 South, 8000 West. Customers and employees are shaken but not injured after those shots were fired into the Wendy's. I was on scene shortly after the shooting and spoke to witnesses. 16-year-old Maya Cruz was inside eating with two friends.
They start shooting. They like took their hand out, start shooting, and they come around and they start shooting the windows. And then me and my friend are just like panicking. We're like screaming.
What's going through your mind as these shots are being fired and the glass is breaking?
I was terrified because I'm pregnant, so I didn't want to get shot at and I wasn't trying to die.
Fortunately, none of the bullets struck anyone inside.
It's just property damage to the Wendy's. Thankfully, nobody was hit. Multiple rounds were shot, and as you can see from the windows, yeah, we're very lucky this afternoon. This is very scary. When you have bullets flying in a residential neighborhood, people sitting down to eat inside Wendy's, it could have been a lot worse than what we're experiencing right now.
Maya Cruz said the intended target was an armed young man inside.
Sent some kid in the Wendy's. He had a gun and he threw it at some girls, and then he picks it up again and then he puts it in his pocket and hides behind us. There was two people that came in and I told them that kid had a gun, and they tried to get it from him and he ran.
Paramedics treated one person at the scene. We're told that person had a panic attack. New tonight, police are searching for an endangered elderly man. 86-year-old Walter Leo Dolter was last seen in South Ogden at 5949 South and 1100 East driving a dark gray blue 2015 Subaru Forester. Police say Walter suffers from dementia and needs his heart medications. They also say Walter speaks fluent German and sometimes forgets he can speak English. If you see Walter, please call Weber County Dispatch. Their number is at the bottom of your screen. It's 801-629-8221. Now to a sinister and sad holiday theft. The Utah Association for Intellectual Disabilities just discovered someone drained their bank accounts. But that's just part of the problem. As Glenn Beebe shows us, the theft is also preventing them from contacting those in need.
To me, it means a lot, because it shows that someone is out there and that cares for us.
For 6 years, Doug Lind and Preston have had their Christmases brightened by the Utah Association for Intellectual Disabilities. Every year, the charity brings gifts for adults, many of whom don't have families and often live in assisted living facilities. That's why they were so angry to hear the charity's funds were wiped out by hackers.
You have to be really low to do something like that to people who don't have that much.
On Wednesday, the group was having their monthly meeting, getting ready for the big holiday push, when they noticed no applications for help had been emailed in since October 22nd.
As we were kind of investigating the email issue, I opened the bank statements and started seeing things that just weren't right.
Bank records showed someone had gained access to their account and within days had drained more than $5,000. But it wasn't just their bank account. The hackers took control of the charity's PayPal, email, and had locked them out of everything, including their website and phone number. Without access to their email, the group can't get the application request for those they serve.
So that's one of the things that's really making us sad, is we don't know who needs help.
While police investigate, the group is now scrambling to make up for lost funds and find volunteers to help make up for lost resources. Reporting in Salt Lake City, I'm Glenn Beebe.
The UAID says anyone who has gotten help from them in the past should call to double-check their applications are in. Because their systems are compromised, those wanting to help donate money or gifts are urged to only call the number on your screen. It's 385-887-4145. You can also find this information on our website, goodforutah.com. Officials want to warn the public about a man accused of raping a 13-year-old girl who was able to sneak into her junior high school during school hours. Our Nick McGurk has been tracking down the facts from police and the Alpine School District and brings us the details.
It's scary that that would happen.
It was the beginning of the school year at Orem Junior High, and police say 19-year-old Joshua Van Sluten had started an online relationship with a 13-year-old student here.
He said, I'm 17-year-old cousin of, you know, so-and-so. Not the case. He's really 19.
The district says Van Sluten arrived here on August 23rd, and at the front office, a school official told him to leave.
They immediately saw that this individual was not identified as somebody who's approved to check out the individual and said, nope, we will not excuse this individual to your care. And so that person left the school building at that time.
This is the old Orem Junior High building. And this, just behind me, is a new detached area. There's a gymnasium, there are classrooms there. Students walk in between these buildings. That's why the doors are sometimes open. And that, according to documents, is where Van Sluten was able to get in and meet up with this 13-year-old victim.
Red flags went up, and they immediately called the parents and got them involved.
According to court documents, after he'd been kicked out of the school, Van Sluten coordinated a meetup with the victim over text message. But after about 2 minutes inside the school, school officials that had been keeping an eye out for the victim that day sprung into action.
This guy's looking at some very, very serious felony charges.
Orem police say if he's convicted, Van Sluten could face prison time after initially meeting the 13-year-old victim on Facebook.
And ultimately, it comes down to we've got to watch out for our kids.
Parents we spoke with say they are disturbed by this story.
Makes you nervous. I mean, I have young kids, and makes you nervous about what the world's coming to. It's scary.
In Orem, I'm Nick McGurk reporting.
Van Sluten has been charged with multiple felonies, from rape of a child to sexual exploitation of a minor. Police say none of the sex crimes happened on school grounds. New developments coming in about Operation Rio Grande. City officials announcing today that the third phase begins tomorrow. The city cleanup project for the Rio Grande neighborhood has met criticism along the way, but after nearly 2 months, the next phase begins tomorrow. The newest focus in Operation Rio Grande is meant to pull public and private partners together to help people with individualized employment plans. The details aren't clear on how the city plans to implement this phase, but elected officials leading the operation will hold an official kickoff press conference tomorrow morning. We will be there and bring you the details on how Operation Rio Grande will progress. Check for that information right here on ABC4 Utah News throughout the day, as well as online at goodforutah.com. Well, marijuana is still on the hit list for DEA agents. Undercover agents arrested two people and their massive stash of marijuana. According to a complaint filed in federal court, the two arranged to sell 100 pounds for $130,000 to buyers who turned out to be undercover agents. The meeting took place at a Salt Lake City motel where undercover agents arrested the two men. Their names are not being released because the investigation is continuing and more arrests are possible. Today, the DEA announced a new plan coming to Utah. The 360 strategy helps cities deal with heroin and prescription drug abuse and violent crime.
We have had people in the trenches. We've known about this for a long time, and so many people have been fighting about this for a long time, but it's only been recently that you see leaders at the federal, state, county, city, and stakeholder level now all standing up and trying to put pressure on all of our other colleagues to say, we have all got to stand up and talk about it.
The plan has been a success in eight other cities, but this is the first time it's been used across an entire state. Agent Brian Besser says Utah is suffering from this epidemic, so they want to make sure all 29 counties take part in the program. Senator Orrin Hatch has been a leader in the fight against opioid abuse. He says he's thrilled the 360 strategy program is launching here in Utah. He says in part, quote, the gravity of the opioid epidemic in Utah cannot be overstated. Consider that each week we lose six Utahns to opioid overdose, a number that has increased 400% in the last 15 years. I believe it will be an incredibly effective strategy in our fight against this devastating opioid epidemic. The suspected killer of a University of Utah student is expected to be formally charged next week. This after a judge granted the Salt Lake County District Attorney an extension. The day after the October 30th fatal shooting of Chinwei Guo, police arrested Austin Boutain at the Salt Lake City Library, and he has been in jail since without official charges. Now, generally, charges are filed within 48 to 72 hours of an arrest. Based on the complexity of this case and the vast number of responding police departments, the Salt Lake County Attorney's Office will file charges by November 16th. Coming up next, a new study shows reading can be good for your health. What kind of benefits can you get from books? That's up next.
And outside tonight on the Colonial Flag Tower camera, once again, a beautiful shot of downtown Salt Lake City. You can see the lights glistening in the background, but there are clouds up here in our sky. We are seeing a little bit of clearing as well. Just how cold will we get tonight compared to last night? We're talking about it.
Hair care for members of the Good For Utah team provided by Michael Stockdale at RMS Studio.
It's the Salt Lake Family Christmas Gift Show this weekend at the Southtown Expo Center. Hundreds of exhibits, thousands of holiday gift ideas, gourmet foods, live entertainment, decorations and ornaments, and pictures with Santa. Kids get in free. For tickets online, see FamilyChristmasGiftShow.com.
Let's go places.
With solar panels from Intermountain Wind and Solar, you'll produce your own electricity and save thousands on your utility bill. Put the longevity and experience of Intermountain Wind and Solar, a SunPower Premier dealer, behind you and calculate how much you can save today.
If you've been injured in an accident, don't just hire any lawyer. Hire the law firm with the best client reviews. How has Robert J. DeBrien Associates achieved these top client reviews? It starts with our six-point client promise. Promise point number six. We promise to help you get 100% of the compensation you deserve as quickly as possible. Your case, our promise. Robert J. DeBrien Associates. Chat with us online right now at robertdebrien.com or call 801-699-9999.
Hello, Utah. We are the Brent Brown Toyota CW30 Street Team.
We'll be visiting events and businesses near you.
If it's going down in your town, the Street Team will be there.
Go to goodforutah.com/streetteam to see where our next adventure takes us.
Or send us an invite. We'd love to attend your event.
Health insurance through U of U Health Plans gives you access to one of the largest provider networks all over Utah. Whether that's in St. George, Salt Lake, or right here in Honeyville.
For anyone who's ever had a brother.
We have a bond that's deeper and more meaningful than any other.
For anyone who's ever raised a child.
You used to say it was a babe magnet.
You used to be little and cute. Now you're just old and in the way.
And for anyone who's ever wondered how you can replace one big star with another big star and still have a hit show.
It's like Charlie Sheen's house.
There's 2.5 Men.
Tonight at 9:30
on Utah's CW30.
You're watching Utah's CW30 News at 9.
It's not just physical exercise that keeps you strong. Mental fitness is important, too. Kim Hutcherson explains how reading for pleasure can be good for your health.
If you want to stay mentally fit, reduce stress, and have better relationships, try picking up a book. Studies indicate reading can improve your life in many ways. Reading can keep your brain sharp and youthful. Studies have shown reading exercises the brain in a way viewing images does not. Reading can slow age-related cognitive decline. One study, published by the National Academy of Sciences, showed that older adults who read regularly or played mentally challenging games were 2.5 times less likely to develop Alzheimer's disease. Reading can help control stress. A study by the University of Sussex in England found that reading can help lower stress levels. Reading can also improve social skills and relationships with others. Many studies have linked reading fiction to better performance on empathy and social awareness tests. In one survey, participants were given a test designed to measure empathy, and another that gauged ability to interpret the mental states of others. Participants who read a lot of fiction scored far higher on measurements of social awareness. For today's Health Minute, I'm Kim Utcherson.
Time now for Utah's most accurate forecast with Adam Carroll.
You know, it's Wednesday, which means it is picture line photo of the day. And here is today's picture line photo of the day from Gavin Rogers. Absolutely beautiful shot of the sunset out there that we had the other day. He called it a washboard type of sunset. You can kind of see that here with the way those clouds were moving across the sky. You add in a little bit of those oranges and those reds and just a wonderful afterglow. Yeah, that's why it's the picture line photo of the day. Send your pictures in to photos for Utah.com, and you may just be one of those winners, and the weekly winner gets a $100 gift card from Pictureline. Peter Sinks, negative 30 degrees this morning, below 30 below this morning here, and by the time we got to midnight, it was already minus 26, so they had a cold night. It's way up there in Cache Valley. It's kind of a big hole in the ground, about 150 feet from its ridge, and it gets cold on the daily this time of year. Look at some of these other ones, Rush Valley 3, Heber 7, Park City 11. It was one of those cold nights. We were hyping it up. We were forecasting it. It definitely lived up to the billing of a cold morning that we definitely had. The first real frosty morning out there in terms of what we saw for our morning lows. Elsewhere, 36 in Provo, 26 Salt Lake. First time we've seen a temperature that cold since February 28th of this year. 9 in Ely, 37 in Lake Powell, 37 also in St. George. High temperatures today. We did get to 51 in Salt Lake. We forecasted 50, so pretty much right there. 41 Vernal, 37 Rock Springs, 55 Ely. Delta was not reporting. Their station is down at the current time frame. 51 Moab and Blanding, and 65, nice and warm down in St. George. We still have a fair amount of clouds out there here on the satellite radar. You can see now a lot of what we're seeing here, the rain and the mixture of rain and snow, most of this is not even hitting the ground. And if it is, it's only in the mountainous areas of Elko County in northwestern Utah. Elsewhere, more clear skies, southeastern portion of the state with a big storm system arriving into the Pacific Northwest. Unfortunately, it's not going to get very far. It's going to stay cool and wet up there. And around here, we're going to be right along that jet stream. So we're going to stay a little bit above average for the next seven days. And we're really not going to see much in the way of wet weather. And if we do, it's just going to graze the northern portions of our state around Cache. Clouds moving out. As we head into tomorrow morning, we'll have a break in the action, some sunshine. Then we'll have more clouds late in the day. So we'll be more partly cloudy to mostly cloudy by the end of the day. We'll have some clouds hanging around much of Friday at times. And that grazer here across northern Utah, maybe bringing in a quick shower to places like Logan. But overall, tomorrow, 58. So, yeah, considerably warmer tomorrow than we saw today out there. A fair amount of cloud cover as well. I mentioned Elko. You're going to see more clouds earlier in the day. So you're going to be mainly cloudy also at Park Valley. 47, but notice how much more we are tomorrow. Now, some of that has to do with clouds allowing for a blanket and bringing a little bit of a warmer air mass, but areas will be colder than they are forecasted because of inversions like Wendover. So keep that in mind. St. George, 73. Absolutely fantastic. You know, Dixie is really where you want to be here all the way through the weekend into next week. 70s, eventually into the 60s. But my goodness, that Veterans Day weekend looks fantastic. For the Wasatch Front, 58 tomorrow, 60 on Friday. Any wet weather that we had in the forecast yesterday, Rick, is gone. So now it's just off and on cloud cover. Veterans Day weekend looks good, including that Utah game. 55 here for the high temperature around kickoff. And then we'll have a little bit more breeze on Monday and warmer. But all in all, Rick, there's no wet weather in our forecast. Not good news for the resorts that really need to snow make all day long, and they're not going to have that opportunity.
So if I went down to southern Utah, would I be able to play golf?
Absolutely. You can golf all you want there, Rick.
Great, because I certainly can't play it up here in Salt Lake City. Thank you. Right. Still to come on the news at 9, a car dealership is helping pave the way for Vietnam veterans to go to the nation's capital to see their monuments. How much money was donated next?
It is absolute chaos out here. Don't know if you can even hear me, but can we get a shot of this cold front right here?
Progress is an unstoppable force. Brace yourself for the Season of Audi sales event.
Want to give your family the best in entertainment and know you're getting big value for your money? Switch to Xfinity and you can get both. Call 1-800-881-7070 and get fast internet and the best in entertainment for $35 each a month for a year when you buy both. Get more of what you want, like Netflix and YouTube, faster and easier with the X1 voice remote. And go mobile with your entertainment with more on-demand titles and DVR recordings to watch anywhere. Plus, with Xfinity XFi, you get the best in-home Wi-Fi experience. Call 1-800-881-7070 and get fast internet and the best in entertainment with your choice of HBO or Showtime for $35 each a month for a year when you buy both, with X1 DVR service free for a year. And ask how to get a $500 prepaid card when you add Xfinity Mobile. You can get Xfinity Mobile included with your internet with up to 5 lines of unlimited nationwide talk and text, so all you pay for is data. See how much value your family can get out of entertainment that brings everyone together. Call 1-800-881-7070 today.
Progress is pioneering performance. Get an exceptional offer on this A3 at your local Audi dealer.
It's time for the Sleep Number semi-annual sale on the only bed that adjusts on both sides to your ideal comfort, your Sleep Number setting. And snoring? Does your bed do that? Right now, during our semi-annual sale, our Queen C4 mattress with adjustable comfort on both sides is only $14.99. Save $300. End soon. Visit sleepnumber.com for a store near you.
A consumer alert to pass along. Amazon Key is now available in Salt Lake City. If you're an Amazon Prime member, you can now have your purchases dropped off inside your home or even let trusted people into your house. If you're worried about just anybody getting into your home, there's no need. When someone shows up to your house for a delivery or just to get inside, Amazon will notify you first. Then, if you approve, Amazon Cloud cameras will record their entire visit. Tonight, 40 Vietnam veterans from Utah are getting ready for a special opportunity tomorrow morning, an honor flight that will bring them to the nation's capital to visit the Vietnam memorials. Thanks to a hefty donation from Nate Wade Subaru, the Utah honor flight is scheduled to take off tomorrow morning around 7. The $40,000 donation makes it possible to send 40 veterans on this once-in-a-lifetime trip.
It means an awful lot. When I was with my brother-in-law, I was pushing him around in a wheelchair, and so I didn't address a lot of the venues that I really wanted to spend time with, the Vietnam Wall, for example. And this time I'm going to be able to take a lot more pictures and be more involved.
The send-off starts early tomorrow morning at 3:30, and the flight leaves at 7. We will have a crew there live for Good Morning Utah. We'll also have a recap on air and online at goodforutah.com. Right now, a petition is circulating around the state of Utah to put medical cannabis on the ballot during the 2018 election. One family says the drug helped their son, so now they're joining the fight for medical cannabis.
We'll always fight for our son. But after knowing what we know and learning what we've learned in Colorado, we're also here to fight for everybody that deserves this access.
Yeah. It's a divisive topic, but both sides are passionate about the same thing, doing what's right for patients. Tonight on our sister station, ABC4 Utah News at 10, we take you inside medical cannabis, a passionate debate. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Good Morning Utah, weekday mornings at 4:30.
For $5, you can get whatever the Taco Randomizer Quiero'd into a box.
Taco Guacarito Supreme.
Or you can get a real meal with the Charbroiled Double Cheeseburger, Spicy Chicken Sandwich, Fries, Drink, and a Cookie. The $5 All-Star Meals, only at Carl's Jr.
Sarah, I wanted to invite you to the premiere Paradise Island.
I can't. I have a furnace inspection.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
There are several benefits to getting your furnace checked. Regular maintenance ensures efficiency and, more importantly, safety. Call a licensed heating contractor to prepare your furnace for winter.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thanks for not just selling me tires. Thanks for doing the work I needed.
Not suggesting stuff I don't.
Thanks for being on the up and up.
And laying off the jargon.
Thanks for not trying to hard sell me.
Twist my arm, sell me.
Or just sell me.
Thanks for the free popcorn.
So thanks.
Thank you.
You're good people.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks for doing the right thing by not just selling me tires.
Welcome. Les Schwab Tires. Doing the right thing matters.
Plan your holidays at the Salt Lake Family Christmas Gift Show this week into the Southtown Expo Center. It's a whole day of fun. Shop thousands of holiday gift ideas, sample gourmet foods, live family entertainment. Kids get in free and free parking. See FamilyChristmasGiftShow.com.
Imagine your life as a medical assistant. With a Fortis medical education, you can work with doctors and patients, helping people in your community with a career you can love. Medical assisting continues to be among the fastest growing occupations nationally. Start your medical career by calling Fortis now at 1-800-555-7600 or visit fortis.edu.
If you missed any of the great CW primetime programs, you can catch up online at goodforutah.com/CW30. Brought to you by The Advocates.
Tempur-Pedic Superior Pressure Relieving Comfort and our 90-day complete satisfaction trial will make tossing and turning a thing of the past. Plus, during our Veterans Day savings event, save up to $500 on select adjustable mattress sets. Find your exclusive retailer at Tempur-Pedic.com.
I need you to help me find my son.
Trust me on this one. Don't make this man angry.
Arrow. Thursday at 8
on Utah's CW30.
If you've got $5, you could make a random meal playing Dollar Menu Bingo.
Anybody have fish sandwich?
Or you can get a real meal with the Charbroil Double Cheeseburger, Spicy Chicken Sandwich, Fries, Drink, and a Cookie. The $5 All-Star Meals, only at Carl's Jr.
Instead of letting off some steam, it was time to let in some steam because today was National Cappuccino Day. Cappuccino is made with espresso, hot milk, and steamed milk foam. The Italian coffee drink got its name from an order of Catholic monks known as the Capuchin Friars. The group wore brown robes similar to the color of the drink. And tomorrow I'll be watching Scarface on a loop all day because it's Al Pacino Day. I'm just kidding.
Is there a Frappuccino Day? Because, you know, we have to have one of those. And cappuccino is something that, you know, you might want to have when it's cooler outside. We're going to have another cold night tonight, and then we're going to actually have some more mild days ahead of us, Rick.
All right. Thank you, Adam, and thank you for watching the CW30 News at 9. Have a great night.
Hey.
Hey.